Tomorrow is Thanksgiving. Food, family, football, Thanksgiving. I love Thanksgiving. And I've heard from many people that Thanksgiving is their favorite holiday as well. And you know, around Thanksgiving, we talk about, we see, you know, people giving thanks and for this and that. You know, our Facebook feeds are full of people counting down the days to Thanksgiving with what they're thankful for. We hear sermons on gratitude, and that's all good. But I want you to think about a favorite meal that you've had. Maybe a time that you were all together for Thanksgiving. Maybe it was a specific food that you like to eat on Thanksgiving. See, as I was trying to think of that myself, I remembered a meal that I had that I shared with my family and a small group of people. We were all sitting on the floor in an empty airport in the middle of Africa, in the country of Burundi. I remember it had been about a week since I'd had anything that resembled a meal. And that was true for most of us in that group. We were tired, we were scared, we were hungry. See, we had just driven into the capital city the night before. We had escaped from the genocide that had just started in Rwanda. We were not able to stay in Burundi because that country was on the verge of a war as well. And as we went through an uncertain night, a group of US Marines had landed at the airport and secured the airport. We got word early that morning saying, if you can make your way to the airport, the US Marines may be able to get us out of the country. So there we were. We were there for several hours. We did not know what was going on. We had seen the Marines outside, so we knew they were around. And as we sat there and waited, the doors opened and a couple of US Marines walked in. They were carrying a box. They set the box on the ground, they opened it up, and they handed us little bags. They were giving us MREs. Meals ready to eat, meals in a bag. I gotta say, that was one of the best meals that I've ever had. I still remember the food. I still remember being so thankful to these guys for giving us this food. I remember being so thankful to these guys because they provided us a way to safety. Well, fast forward years later, I was sitting in Pastor Tim's house in Denver, Colorado. It was a birthday party or something like that, and I was talking to one of his neighbors. We were talking about, you know, the places we had visited and the countries that we'd been to. And then he tells me this story. He's like, oh, by the way, and one of the countries I went to was this little country called Burundi. I went there when I was in the Marines. He said it was this really weird trip because him and his group of Marines were headed home when they were diverted to Burundi and asked to secure the airport and to help this small group of people escape the country. And he said it was this weird little stop off, but I guess that's one of the countries I've been to. And the way he talked about it, it was just this this inconvenience, this thing that cut his that took away from him being able to make it back home on time. For me, that story was the story of one of the best meals that I had ever had. Sometimes God puts us in a place that may seem very insignificant to us. In fact, sometimes it may be a bother, or sometimes it may be downright inconvenient. But God wants us there because somebody else needs us there. This Thanksgiving, I would like to challenge us to be willing to be used by God so that somebody else can be thankful. You know, this song has, I heard this song the other day on the radio, and it's been bouncing around my head. It's a song called Do Something. God is calling us to do something. God wants to touch this world through us. As we listen to the song, I pray that you'll be willing to be God's hands and His feet so that somebody else can be thankful.
This morning, saw a world full of trouble. Now I thought, how do we ever get so far down, and how's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. Yeah. I created you. If not us, then who? If not me and you, right now. Well, it's time for us to do something. Something. So tired of talking about how we are God's hands and feet, but it's easier to say than to be. Live like angels of apathy. We tell ourselves it's alright, somebody else will do something. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm sick and tired of life with no desire. Says, I'm gonna do something. If not us, then who? If not me and you, right now. It's time for us to do something. Yes, it is. Change the world.